been me. If you've been with me from Port of Miami, it's been a journey. Ain't nothing changed. A little stronger, a little wiser. Maybe a little more. Blame it on America.
I'm pulling off the lot, I bought the cash. Whoa. Our future bright, don't give nobody a pass. Whoa. Be looking good inside the body. Whoa. But I notice that she missing all the edges. Whoa. I run the game just by running with the running. Whoa. Poor attitude, they got rich calisthenics. Whoa. Walking in the courtroom, sipping on the beverage. Whoa. I know the judge, so I got a lot of leverage. Whoa. Rapping a cappella. Whoa. Kim Trezor, people with the weapon. Whoa. I got it. Boy, don't make me be the devil. Whoa. He knocking on the door and know the best word. Gave me his blessings while I'm hotter than the last verse.
Dear president, dear president. Dear president, get them dead presidents.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Today's matchup features the top scoring pass offense in the NFL. The Cardinals are top 10 in passing TDs, and they'll go against the Seahawks, who are very aware of what they'll be dealing with.
Thank you, Larry. It hosted Super Bowls 42 and 49, and it's University of Phoenix Stadium. That's where we're at in Glendale, Arizona. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Seattle Seahawks and the Arizona Cardinals. Set to go now in week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Oh, he's got a little daylight. He finds an opening past the 40. Shifts past him at the 45. A big seam, and he might go all the way. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. A big play there with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead. And this will give the Seahawks a 7-0 lead. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Get him back to the 25, but that's going to be in. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Just a two-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on fourth down. Here comes the Cardinals punter now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out. Well, not only did they try to fake it, they put the ball in the arm of their punter, and it didn't work out.
Not the quarterback.
No.
The punter.
Yeah. Risky.
And it's so funny because when it works, genius. When it doesn't work, not so smart.
Not so
in this case, not so genius, but I do admire that he went for it.
Down to the 30 after a gain of three.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast. Knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a third and five. They'll run it now out of the gun. They showed off a nice juke of the defender, but the next wave there to bring him down. It's a five-yard pickup, but spotted a few chain links short of the first, so a little bit of decision time here coming up on fourth down. So out now is the Seattle field goal team. This a 40-yard attempt from the left half. And his kick here is good. And the lead moves to 10-0. So he splits the uprights there, and I would imagine it's nice as a kicker. Right when it leaves your foot, you know it's good.
Yeah, it's kind of like a golfer that picks up his tee after a nice drive without even watching it land.
Solid analogy. I like it. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And the Cardinals getting set to trot out there now. Here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. And they're behind the sticks here a bit now, dealing with a second and 12. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Off the play. play fake. He'll look to throw. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard.
All right, here we go. Over, 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 over. Let's go. Detroit, Detroit. Over, 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 over. Set, Green, Leopard, Leopard. Hurry up.
They're going to try and throw. Steps away, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Seahawks, they'll get the football back in outstanding field position. And a great spot to start this drive from here. And now here's a carry heading left. Stops short of the 25, but that second effort got him a couple extra. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
All right, here we go.
And to give this time to the tailback. Down to the 25. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a third and three. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
A first scoring update now from Carolina, and it's the Panthers there out to the early advantage. And we'll keep an eye on that one as our game goes along here. The first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue. So it'll be first down here after the run. Try the right side here. He'll get forward for 3 down to the 16-yard line.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. Switch it up here and look to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10. And look out, a big hit to the shoulder pads took him right off his feet at the 1-yard line. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's 1st and goal. Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run.
Here we go now.
And he'll give it here to his running back. No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down. Through the contact, and he gets halfway home from the four down to the 2 yard line.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get a second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier, was bidding for a second. As he's down to the 2 yard line. Only a yard that time, so now a decision to be made here on fourth and goal. And this one is right through. And that'll push the lead up to 13 to nothing. So it's an old school extra point, but certainly a disappointment that they couldn't get six.
Yeah, when you see 19 yard field goal in the box score, you kind of shake your head. But their head coach decided three was enough.
That'll be taken in the end zone. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. It's been an awfully slow start for them. This is their third possession. They don't have a first down yet.
So that means they have to change up what they're doing. And for some teams, it's a change in tempo, usually moving it to more up-tempo type of an offense just to try and change their fortunes right now. What they've been doing so far isn't working. Maybe they'll do that.
Play fake here on first down. Trying to lay one up deep. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all. And I understand why. They've looked lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. Looking for a seam but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down.
While there's no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And fortunately for him, he's able to get it back, but it will be a loss on the play.
Well, that was a big oops right there. But how about his ability to correct it? Loses the football, able to get it back himself.
Yeah, pounced right back on it, keeps possession. He punted four times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. And they won't get a chance to bring this one back. It goes out of bounds, back near their own 20. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Too much.
I don't know about that. Super tall.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Check, dropped to throw. The Cards get to him here. He's brought down for a sack.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
The Seahawks on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be third and 15. Now with a play clock at 4, we're going to get a timeout called. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. The Seahawks on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be third and 15.
Here we go, Nick.
He'll look to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. And they pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
The Seahawks send out their punter as he's on here to punt it away. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. Taking it about the 16. A great blocking nearly sprung in there. 28-yard return. And this offense will take over right at the midfield stripe with a first and 10. Game clock sitting at 2:02, so they'll get one play before the two-minute warning. Now a handoff looking right. And some room to work. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A minute 57 to go in this first half. More from the desert after this. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Try the right side here. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
No gain on that run, and while this team is down, they're not out of it by any stretch of the imagination. Maybe you just have to think about different style of running in order to get this guy going.
Throw here on second and 10. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back.
I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. 10 yards to go on third. Now back to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they've rallied and made the tackle.
And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And they will indeed get on the board here, but still trailing. It's now 13-3. So they recover the fumble but could not take advantage of the short field. They do get three.
And no one ever turns down 3 points going up on the board, but the offense will go to the sidelines wondering what if, while the defense on the other side, they'll celebrate holding them to just a field goal after giving up such bad field position.
And out now come the Seahawks. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
And not a whole lot doing there, so he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Now here's a timeout defensively coming from the Cardinals. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Second down following the run. As they run the counter play, and they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. And now the Cardinals going to use another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. The Seahawks on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This will be third and six. And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. The Seahawks send out their punter on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. Around the NFL, we've got a second quarter score. It's the Raiders with the early lead over the Broncos. And we'll keep you abreast of how that one shakes out. And this will carry out of bounds. Where are they going to spot it now? At about the 18-yard line, it looks like. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down. But tapping those toes, he tried to get both in bounds. He could not do it, though.
In tap dance parlance, could not complete the shuffle. All right, needed to get that shuffle down with both feet, not just one.
Is that what they said? And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been under constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. The Cardinals on third down. Not good. 0 for 4 thus far. This will be third and 15. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Pressure gets to him and down he goes. Back at the 4-yard line.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
So we've come upon halftime with the visiting Seahawks. They're out in front. As we send you on down to our studios in Orlando, we're standing by. And no update from Larry this week, apparently. We'll try again in week 7. But for now, let's get back to the action, ready to kick off the second half. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. They've gone to the second quarter now in Denver. It's the Raiders with the early lead over the Broncos. I have a feeling that one's going to stay tight throughout. We'll continue to monitor. So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never wanted to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But
this is I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. This time to the tailback. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Up near the 45 at the 44. It's a gain of 5, and that'll bring up a third down.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually it was. It was a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ikey's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Well, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile with their feet. He showed the agility there with a toe tap.
No doubt about it. It's like he'd run to ballet school. Got the toes down and stayed in bounds.
Now out of the gun and some room to roam now and brought down, but the juke, the very nice juke, gives him the first down yardage there. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set.
Watch it now, Barney, Barney. Back to that end, Philly, here we go. Over.
They go play action here on first down. On the move to his, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness of that defensive line is eating them alive.
He's going to wind up and air it out. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on. Third down. It's been this way most of the afternoon, hasn't it? This secondary, it really put this receiving core on lockdown.
Listen, they've worked together like a basketball team that's playing excellent defense. Great communication, doesn't matter whether it's man or zone. And especially against deep balls, as we saw there, they're not giving up anything to them.
The Cardinals on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is third down and 12.
They'll look to throw here. And he comes back with one complete. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. Some space here, and able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Now a handoff looking right, and he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
But they're getting ready to go to work now in prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot and picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Well, he had 2 sacks earlier. Now he has 4 total tackles for a loss after that play.
Well, they obviously have to do a better job trying to block him. But short of that, you know what the quarterback has to do? Make sure he doesn't hand it to him when he's back there thinking he's one of his own guys. His quickness, his suddenness, his speed getting into the offense's backfield has been something else in this game.
He'll drop to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 5 yards on the pickup, and all of a sudden here, it's third down. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. Back to throw. Escaping the pressure right. This is caught. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post route?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession, and that was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
And not a whole lot doing there, so he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. A gain of 3, second down. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Now they'll run on the draw. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Elsewhere, they have gone to the second half in Carolina. The Redskins have scored yet again. They've really opened that one up.
Green,
Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. And he'll give it here to his running back. And a good burst there gets him 7 up to midfield.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Three yards to go here on second down.
All right, now, Lockett 56. Lockett's got the 6.
Now a handoff here to his running back. They got 2 of the 3 they needed there. Leaves them with 3rd and just 1 yard.
If they're going to get a first down out of this, they're going to have to earn it because there's been tough going in the interior there. And here we are on 3rd and 1. Be prepared. Brace yourself. There'll be some contact.
The Seahawks on 3rd down, just 1 for 5 to this point. They're up against a 3rd and 1 situation. Now they try the right side here. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. Now they'll run on the draw. Oh, he sheds himself free. And he is going to feel that one. Knocked down hard at the 21-yard line. Just 2 yards to go here on 2nd down for the offense. Now they'll run it on the toss. Fights him off. He's to the 10. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. A great play there. His first touchdown on the year. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field, and they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive, but they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
They'll look to throw now on 1st down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Welch. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. 3 yards remaining here on 2nd down. They'll look to throw. Escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. 6 sacks given up in this one.
The Cardinals on 3rd down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This is 3rd and 9. They'll set up a throw. They'll roll him out right. Thrown across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 36.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. The slot man in motion right. Now a handoff as they run left side. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Now they'll run it on the toss. And able to fight forward inside the 15 to the 13. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves them with a 2nd and 3. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Offense staying ahead of the chains here, 2nd and 3.
Back to the NFL. Here we go. Here we go now. Watch it now. Barney, Barney. All right, here we go.
And now here's a carry heading left. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a 3rd down and 2. The 4th quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Under 4 to play now. Clock running. 3rd down. Oh, no. He lost the football.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
So they settle for just the 3 there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the 4th.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But 3 does give them some breathing room and lets them build up a little cushion.
That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on 1st down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Back to throw here. And the Seahawks defense gets to him, and they bring him down. Offensively, they're going to have to figure this out before next week. 7 sacks in 1 game.
Yeah, and that's more than any quarterback should have to bear. And if this continues on, there will be another quarterback in the game, because no one can stand up to this week after week.
On play action, they'll throw. He sets to fire deep. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a 4th down. Definitely desperation time. This just looks like, hey, throw it down there, hope that your guy can make a play.
You want him to make a play, but if not, maybe you get a pass interference call. And you know, in the NFL, that's a spot foul. You get all that yardage. That would be a big play.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out.
Here we go now. Blue landing. Blue landing.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. Flush to his right. Now a desperation. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off at the 46. And they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. And here comes throw number one for the backup QB. And some room to maneuver. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now a handoff looking right. And an alley to run. 20. And all the way in. Touchdown, Seattle. A great effort there. With two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the interception by the Seahawks D leads to a touchdown.
Back there, not Philly. Here we go. Hurry up, here we go.
Now they send the tight end in motion left. They'll try and run it up the middle. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll probably wish he'd reconsidered here. It will cost him 10 yards as he's down at the 15.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Now they try the right side here. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. On second down, they'll try and run the counter. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. And a nice carry there of 15 yards. And now the Seahawks are going to call another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Side of midfield. That one goes for 24 yards. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right down your throat.
And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 4 on the ground there. They're now left with 3rd and 6.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
Back down, Philly. Here we go.
Check. 4 down. 4 down.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that's going to be just about all she wrote for this one. Give it here to his running back. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Now here's a timeout defensively coming from the Cardinals. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Now it looks like he'll throw here. And he will find his man on the outside. And here come the whistles and a timeout. With 7 seconds left. Well, a clear running situation, trying to take time off the clock. You ran the previous play, set that play action up nicely.
Boy, did they ever, because they had shown the ability to run the football. So now you lose your keys as a defense. You dive for the running play, and they hit them over the top.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to air one out. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
They decided to take a shot and right down the middle of the field. And really, they didn't give it as much time to develop, did they? They want to take that shot somewhere around the 15-yard mark.
And the defense, able to recover, bat it free. Then with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. To throw. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. Past the 20. And he takes it in for the score on the game's final play. So it doesn't affect the outcome, but a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
Or as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lagniappe, a little extra on top.
And if the late touchdown wasn't bad enough, now they're going to go for two. So sportsmanship nowhere to be found right here. They're going to keep it on the ground. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more. So they kept it on the ground, got it into the end zone. But Charles, sometimes you probably see teams treat a two-point conversion differently than if it was first and goal from the two, or I should say third and goal from the two.
I agree with you totally on that. A lot of teams treat it as if they have farther to go and shy away from running the football. I think this is a great spot to do it because most teams play you for the pass. Go ahead and run it, let your linemen surge and fire out.